I told her it was in high school. Yeah, I was very scared to walk through the kitchen. I seen some doing this. I'm ready.
I might fuck up the mic though.
Yeah.
Everybody, please take your seats. I'm going to work this mic pretty good. First, I'd like to begin by welcoming everyone and thanking everyone for being here today. It's no accident that each of you is here today, and each of you was invited to be here because you represent someone important in the individual and collective lives of Josh and Skyler. I can't think of a better venue for an occasion that I know is not only monumental for the wedded couple to be, but for all of us who are lucky to know and love them. The most remarkable moment in life is when you meet the person who makes you feel complete, the person who makes the world a beautiful and magical place, the person with whom you share a bond so special that it transcends normal relationships and becomes something so pure and wonderful that you can't imagine spending another day without them in their life. For Josh, that happened about 20 years ago when he met me and we became best friends.
Love you.
But about 10 years ago, he met Skyler, who I guess is pretty wonderful too.
So convinced.
I know how deeply that they care for and love one another, and I feel privileged and honored that they chose me to be up here today among all of you as a witness of their commitment to a lifetime of love for one another. I wish I could tell you a single story about Josh and Skyler that summarizes their relationship, but the truth is there isn't one single event that can describe that. But I can tell you a story about how their love story began about 7 years ago. That's when I close this. So if some of you guys know, Josh and Skyler, they met, and they were pretty good friends at St. Joe's, along with me. I'm like the third wheel. And Skyler gave Josh an opportunity to have a job at Wadico. And if you want to know what Wadico is, there's actually plenty of people in this crowd you could ask about, and they could tell you some stories, because that is one hell of a place to work. Or be a slave. So about 7 years ago, I'd say, Josh invited a bunch of us to go up to his house, kind of like a reunion for some high school people, college people. And, you know, when at any reunion, you have a few drinks. And when I mean a few, probably too many. And, you know, it's not the story, Nick, don't worry. It's not the one where you were sleeping with the cooking pot. different night. So Josh and I are in a conversation, and he quietly drops the, you know, I think I love Skyler. And I looked at him and was like, yeah, me too, man. Like, I'm thinking he's talking about being friends with her. Yeah, yeah, I love her too. She's great. And no, he's like, no, dude, I like really love her. And I was like, okay, have you told her that? And he, you know, responded, which I respected. He said, you know, I didn't want to mess up the friendship and kind of their living situation because they were living together as friends with other people. And so, like any good friend, I totally ignored that. And probably about 5 minutes later, I walked across the room, saw Skyler. Hey, Skyler, how's your night going? He said, oh, it's great, yeah. By the way, Josh loves you, so you guys should probably figure that out. And yeah, great party. I'll see you later. And here we are today. You're welcome. Pretty accurate. Since that time, I have witnessed both of them care deeply and passionately for each other. They protect each other, they make each other laugh, and think outside themselves. They help each other in ways that are obvious and unnoticed, but always appreciated. They balance one another, and while each of them is tremendous individuals on their own, together they're even better. And being better together as a team, a unit, and partners in crime is what has been many years in the making and led us to this moment today. Witnessing their commitment to one another in front of those they love most. Josh and Skyler, we are gathered here today to join you in union of marriage. This contract is not to be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, and with deep realization of its obligations and responsibilities. The bride and groom have both prepared vows that they will read now. I don't remember which one you guys are, so.
First? Yeah. Josh, when we first met at St. Joe's, I knew that you were going to be in my life. If you asked me then if we would end up here today, I would have said no. We're just friends. I would have said, no, we're just friends. You know that thing you say when you really care about someone, but never know if you ever would actually have a chance or a real future with that person. But then you crawled into my bed and never left. Thanks to Matt, or maybe Adam. Who knows? I think it was that same night you just referred to, Matt. Even before that moment, Josh, I may not have been willing to admit it, but I had always known you were my person. And every day we have spent together over the years just continues to reassure me that you are my forever. You have stuck by me for my not-so-fine moments, such as throwing your phone down a flight of stairs and saying, people don't forget. Or me showing up at the house with 10 miles left in my tank, running in, grabbing your keys, and leaving with your car. Then there are the unforgettable moments we have created with friends, family, and of course, Manny and Axel. Josh, I admire your drive to learn, your resilience, and your ability to never take a single moment for granted. Every day, you make me see and feel how loved I am by you. You are so mindful and considerate in every way possible. When we have had to go through adversity, loss, and in taking challenging steps to better our future, such as moving down here to the Sunshine State. Seeing how far we have come makes me even more excited to see our future. As we take the next step towards our future, I promise to never lose our spark, to always do the little things, to make you happy, to prioritize you, be there for you when things get tough, communicate with you, and never let go. And always remember, don't ever leave me, because I'll find you.
How am I supposed to follow that? Oh, well, Alexi, just put that away. Skyler, standing here looking at you, I know the same thing now that I knew 7 years ago. When I looked at Matt and I said, Matt, I love her. Yeah. And when I say that, I mean I am truly, madly, and deeply in love with you. Okay. Before I talk about that, I wanted to touch upon the years where I met you and how my feelings began. By now, I believe everybody here knows that Skyler and I met at St. Joseph's College back in 2010. It didn't take long for our paths to cross there. Okay. You see, when I was younger, I hadn't thought much of what I was really looking for in a wife, or a partner, or anybody for that matter. Okay. And just like that, God said, insert Skyler. This fun, energetic, and positive force that just blew me away. And I knew she was the one for me. For 4 years, our friendship continued to grow and eventually into something more. And I'm so grateful that we spent those 4 years together just as friends, learning who we are, and now learning who we're gonna be. All right, now that I've covered a bit of backstory, that's the tough part. I want you to know how important these last 7 years of my life have been, all because of you. You've shown me patience at times when I deserve to be strangled. You have shown me compassion at times when I felt like I didn't deserve any. And you have shown me love, a love that runs so deep, I feel it in my bones. I could stand up here and talk about you forever. But to close it out, I just want you to know that I am so grateful you decided to say yes and spend the rest of your life with me. And I'm going to try every day for the rest of our lives to be the man that you deserve. I love you. Do we kiss now?
I'm a kisser.
Wow. Jesus.
And now, Josh, do you take Skyler to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore?
I do.
You sure?
I'm sure.
I was just checking. And Skyler, do you take Josh to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only unto him forevermore?
I do.
Final answer?
Yep.
Okay. Can't take that back. Josh and Skyler will now exchange rings as a symbol of love and commitment to each other. Rings are precious metal. They are also made precious by you wearing them. Your wedding rings are special. They enhance who you are. They mark the beginning of your love, your long journey together. Your wedding ring is a circle, a symbol of love never ending. It is the seal of the vows you have just taken to love each other without end. Adam, give this dude the ring. Josh, please place the ring on Skyler's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
That I have chosen you.
That I have chosen you.
Above all else.
Above all else.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed. This is really tight.
I just want to make sure I look good in the picture. And Skyler, please place this ring on Josh's left hand and repeat after me. Good luck. As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
That I have chosen you.
That I have chosen you.
Above all else.
Above all else.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed. You got that.
All right, let's switch this up. The guy didn't tell me to move the mic, but I'm gonna. Josh and Skyler would like to conclude today's services with a sand ceremony. They have gathered each of you here to be part of the ceremony as they make their lifelong commitment to each other. Skyler and Josh, please pick up the vases of sand. I asked to be in this, but they didn't let me. Today you are here to join both of your lives together. These two separate vases of colored sand, one that represents Josh and one that represents Skyler. These vases of sand symbolize your separate lives before you found each other. They symbolize your separate friends, family, and journeys. Stop pouring that. Today, both of you seal your bond by combining these individual vases together. As the two containers of sand are poured into the vase, the separate colors of sand now blend into a new color. Just as individual grains of sand can no longer be separated, may your relationship also be inseparable. To make your relationship work will take love. Continue to date each other. Take time to show each other that your love and marriage grow stronger with time. It will take trust to know that in your hearts you truly want what's best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn and grow together. It also take dedication because you're now a Bills fan, so good luck with that. Just despair. It will take loyalty to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings. It will take Skyler letting Josh hang out with me whenever it wants, please. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you have both pledged today. Josh and Skyler, you have come here today on your own free will, I think. And in the presence of family and friends, have declared your love and commitment to each other. You have given and received a ring as a symbol of your promises by the power of your love and commitment to each other and the power invested in me. That's important. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Josh and Skyler, you may now share your first kiss.
Keep me from getting to you.
the wedded couple asked that at this time, guests, you can go to the cocktail under the Tiki Hut. Someone get me a drink. And immediate family, stay here for pictures. Thanks. Yeah.